As research advances, more clinical trials are investigating gene addition therapies for Friedreich's ataxia, or FA. By addressing the root cause of FA, gene addition therapies bring hope, but they also come with complexity and limitations. If you or a loved one are considering a clinical trial, it's important to understand how gene addition therapy works and to ask questions before making a decision. FA is caused by extra GAA repeats in the FXN gene, which reduces production of a protein called frataxin. Frataxin is involved in the cell's process of creating energy. Low levels of frataxin result in low cellular energy, which impacts many tissues and organs, including the brain, spinal cord, peripheral nerves, heart, muscles, pancreas, and eyes. Gene addition therapy uses a viral vector, which acts like a delivery truck to deliver a healthy copy of the FXN gene to your cells. Once there, the healthy gene begins producing frataxin, which may slow or stop the progression of FA, and in some cases might even reverse some damage, and its effects may last for several years. Each investigational gene addition therapy is unique. Most gene addition therapies use adeno-associated viruses, or AAVs, for delivery. Each AAV delivers their genetic cargo to different organs. One might target the heart, while another might target both the brain and the heart. How the therapy enters the body also impacts which organs it can reach. Gene addition therapy may be administered through an IV or direct injection into the brain or spinal fluid. Each approach has different potential risks and benefits that should be discussed with your healthcare team beforehand. Even though AAVs don't cause illness, your body still treats them like invaders and mounts an immune response. As part of the immune response, your body develops antibodies. The presence of these antibodies makes you ineligible for receiving gene addition therapies in the future. Other considerations to keep in mind include: two gene therapies targeting the same organs can differ in how many cells they reach within the organ and the amount of frataxin produced. Gene addition therapy is not reversible and may make you ineligible for other clinical trials. Trials often start with lower doses to establish safety, so early participants may receive doses that might be less effective. Participation in a gene addition trial may require additional invasive procedures and long-term follow-up. Like any medical intervention, there are potential risks, including severe immune system reactions, surgical complications when brain delivery is used, and, in rare cases, death. After receiving genetic therapy, you should avoid contact with other people who have FA for several weeks to prevent affecting their eligibility for treatment. Gene addition therapy is one of the most exciting areas of research in FA today. Deciding to join a trial is complex, and the right choice may look different for each person. If you're considering joining a trial, talk with your healthcare team and the study team. FARA's Clinical Trials 101 guide has some sample questions to help get you started.